My name is Abdul Wahab and today our topic is 2D and 3D scanners. So if I talk about 2D and 3D scanners, the purpose of scanner is to scan something. Like if I talk about a simple scanner, that can be like it will convert from hard copy to soft copy. So it means hard copy is the paper you have, and if you are going to scan in digital form, that will be used through the 2D scanner. 2D is two dimensional scanner. So we have only two coordinates in it, x axis and y axis. So the hard copy will be of is following in a two way direction only. So the purpose of scanner is to scan from the hard copy to the soft copy. Soft copy is the digital form, and hard copy is the form you have in the physical form, like that can be a document, that can be an image document, it can be a text document, whatever you have. Fine. Furthermore, we have, like, if you talk about scanner, like all scanners are 2D scanners. You have photocopy machines, those are scanners as well. Alright? So those are lying in the category of 2D scanner. So the image is converted into the electronic form, that is digital form, that is zeros and ones form, and it can be stored in the computer later on. So once the image has been stored in the computer, it will be definitely in a digitized form, that is zeros or ones form. Now we talk about another scanner that is called 3D scanner. 3D scanner is, as we have discussed, in 2D scanner we have two coordinates, x-axis and y-axis. So for the 3D scanner, we have the scanner, the purpose of the 3D scanner is that it will scan the solid objects and it will produce three-dimensional image. It will just scan the image, it will not print the image. For that purpose, you need a printer, that is 3D printer. Once you have scanned the object, that will be stored, and usually we talk about image is called CAD document, computer aided design. Alright, so we'll talk about later on. So solid objects are scanned through it, and then you can take a print out through the 3D scanner, 3D printer. So solid objects can have x-axis, y-axis and z-axis coordinates in it. So it means every image will be scanned through the three using these three coordinates. Furthermore, we have these scanners can take the several points of an image along with these coordinates. Suppose I am talking about one object, suppose it's an object. So if I capture from this way and then I capture from this way, so there are might be possible there are hundred or millions of images I have taken from this rotation to this rotation. So it will be scanned by the 3D image. Further, if I talk about, as you have already understood, like technologies used in the 3D scanner are laser technologies, magnetic resonance, and the white light. If I talk about these applications, you have already listened this term very frequently, like CT scan. So CT stands for computed tomographic, and this uses X-rays at the back end. Furthermore, we have MRI. These are the terms used in medical. And MRI stands for magnetic resonance image, and these are using radio frequency or radio waves at the back end. The last one is SPECT. SPECT is used as a single photon emission computed tomography, and we use gamma rays for it. I'm sure this is clear to all of you, and thank you very much.